Hi and welcome to this, an inbox review of the MiG21-F-13 Fishbed C by Revell in 1/72 scale. I was asked to do an inbox review of this by a friend who recently reviewed a trumpeter MiG21-F-13, the early version of the MiG21. So here goes. Here's the box art. It shows the Russian aircraft and a wingman shooting down something American. It's just box art at the end of the day. But for me, the interesting part is this. It has the East German version. On the sides of the box, as usual, pictures of parts of the finished kit. It shows that you get the Soviet and East German version. And it's skill level 3. And the back of the box, the usual adverts for other Revell products. Not surprisingly in the box, but here we go, you get the instructions, 3 silver sprues, 1 clear sprue, separately bagged, and 1 set of transfer.
Okay, let's take a look at the plastic. So here's sprue 1, with a fuselage half, wing parts, horizontal stabilizers, and this is cockpit parts and gear bays. So let's have a look at some of the detail. So that's what an inbox review is for, isn't it? You all know there's an aeroplane in here, but what is the quality? Well, there's the detail on the fuselage. Finely detailed rivets. You can hardly feel them, but they are recessed nicely. And that continues all over the kit. Nice detail up here on the top. The wings are similar, lots of tiny little rivets, wheel detail there. All the parts seem to have the same sort of level of detail, it's quite nice. Here is the cockpit tub. You can see it has various controls moulded in. Remember, it is 1/72, so it is quite small. This, I don't know if that's the pitot tube, sticks out the front of the aircraft, I don't think it was a refueling tube. Rocket pods. Once again with detail on. We have pylons with nice detail. The two-part seat with moulded in belts, which is something I don't generally like, and I usually remove them, but getting into here to remove them might be difficult, so we'll see. And this is the gear bays for the main wheels and the front wheel. So that's one sprue. The next sprue is another fuselage half and various parts. So it's the same level of detail, of course, because it's just the other half of the fuselage. And then we have things on larger pylons. This, I believe, is some sort of air brake system. I think that recess there is where a part goes for an air brake. And once again, the same level of detail. The final sprue appears to be more doors, gear doors. I think these are the air brakes. We've got the air intake at the front, the exhaust. I believe that's the inside of the engine. This is a three-part auxiliary fuel tank. Bombs with shackles, gear leg. I mean, no surprise to what you get, but it shows you the level of detail. That is the rear of the fuel tank, and the rest of the bombs there. Okay, on to the clear parts. So here we are. We have a two-piece canopy. Strangely for this early MiG-21, it doesn't hinge sideways. It doesn't hinge backwards. It hinges forward from the front of the canopy. So this entire bit hinges forwards, and that stays at the back. And I believe this part here goes inside. I have a couple of little landing lights here, and then here is the, if I can get, the instrument panel. You can see some of the detail on there, and there's not too much lensing, a little bit, but not massive amount. So it seems like half decent clear parts.
Okay, the transfers. Protective film, of course. We have Soviet stars and numbers for the Soviet version. And my particular interest, East German national insignia and East German numbers. And a reasonable amount of stenciling. There is the instrument panel, which looks quite busy. You see a lot of instrument panels that are just black and white, and that has some more detail on it. You can see though, especially here on the numbers, although the transfers appear to be quite thin, they're quite matte. And there's a lot of carrier film, especially around those numbers. The others, very little because they're simple shapes, but the numbers, some of the film may have to be removed from those. So that's the transfers. Okay, the instructions. Finally, as usual with Revell, or at least the older Revell, they've changed it recently. A4 leaf booklet. So, picture of the completed model and history and stats that you usually get. This is, of course, just the bit you always read, don't you? Always read it. Look, this is what glue is. Glue this, don't glue this, what's this? This description about how to read the instructions. Okay. Love it or hate it. Colour call out. Revell colour call out. And everyone, of course, loves the mixtures they have to do. So, colour call outs, sprue map, quite useful, of course. So, step one. The assembly of the seat, it looks to be in 1, 2, 3 pieces. Shows you how to paint it and the angle that, things should be at. Then the assembly of the cockpit tub with the control column and the instrument panel, how to paint it, get the transfer off. Then the tub goes into the fuselage and that tells you how to paint detail that's on the inside of the fuselage as well, there's a little bit there. How to paint the wheel well, which fits here. And the wheel well for the main gear and the engine at the back. Step 4 is the other side, how to paint the inside of the cockpit tub on that side and insert the wheel well. Then simply stick the two halves together and then, as you would expect, you're adding the wings and the other flying surfaces, showing you how to paint it, and same on the other side, the same instructions. And then you start adding all the little bits. This here, this lump that goes on the side, I believe it's an air brake. You can have it in or out, which makes me suspect that it's an air brake. And this is just a mirror of that on the other side and various other parts. More lumps and bumps. Details to add on. And the same on the other side for number 11. Adding the air intake, telling you to put it straight up and down and across. And addition of the front undercarriage. Gear doors for the front, and then 14 and 15 are how to attach the main gear, showing you that this needs to be at an angle of 45 degrees, bent out by 4 millimeters, so clear stuff there. Another lump, don't know what piece of equipment that is, and then the addition of the door, and then we've got repeat for the other side. Stage 19 is attaching the auxiliary fuel tank and pylons and looks like some other sort of pitot tube type device, number 55. And the same on the other wing. Then the question mark, do you want them? Do you want the rocket pods? And this is how to assemble and paint. Or you could have two bombs. This is how to assemble and paint. This shows you can have the rocket pod attached, the bomb attached, or the empty pylon attached, or the pylon with this on. I don't know what that is, but that can be attached. So there's your options, and the same on the other side. Then, only then, do you attach the seat and the rear of the canopy. Then we have the rest of the canopy in the inner parts, nothing else there, some sort of antenna. You can have it close,
or you can have it open. I'll probably go for the open because I like open cockpits. Addition of what I think is a pitot tube. And then we're on to the scheme. So you can get Blue 66 Air Defence Guard Regiment, 32nd Air Defence Guard Regiment, sorry, USSR 1961. And it's an all-over aluminium scheme with a different colour around the engine, of course. And shows you transfer placement, as you would expect. A very simple scheme. The painting guide for the East German version, 1963-65, is the same colour callouts, except for little changes. And then, of course, the German insignia and number instead. That's the instructions. This is a 2015 rebox of Revell's own 2004 tool. I'm quite impressed with the detail at 1/72 scale. I think it sells for about £13-14. I got it cheap on an offer, but I think, well, looking at it so far before I built it, at the moment it seems good value for money. Okay, so there you have it, an inbox review of the MiG21-F-13 Fishbed C by Revell in 1/72 as requested. Thanks for watching, I hope this has been useful. So until next time, keep modelling and have fun. Bye.